Hey YouTube, we're back again today with another little project, and our goal today, we're going to take this little piece of cherry and we're going to make a snowman. Snowman is a good little practice project. It's a good beginner's project. It will introduce you to the tools, some of the tools we use. It's kind of cool this morning. It was 33 degrees in Alabama. Can you believe that? All right, well, first thing we're going to do is mark the centers and get it between centers. Put my live center in. And you should mark them. I've been doing this a while though, and I can pretty well hit the center. It's not hard to see a center or something like that. So, we're going to take some mallet and whop it in there. By the way, mallets are great little projects too. Bring your tailstock up. You probably need to adjust it just a little bit. Looks pretty good right there. You know, I'm self-taught pretty much between YouTube and trial and error. And I never know how tight to make my tailstock. And you got your live center there. I'd usually just crank it up until I can't turn it my fingers but no more. And you gotta go back and check it now and then. Get our tool rest adjusted. This is a spindle roughing gouge. Okay. You never want to use this in a bowl. Not a good idea. The tang is not strong enough, and it's not in there very far either. It's great on spindles. When we call it, say, spindles, spindles are long grain work, or where your grain runs parallel with the bedways of the lathe. This would be face grain, or when you or reorient it the other way, it would. It's just the nature of the way it cuts. A bowl gouge you would use it on the other direction, because a bowl gouge has a lot stronger tang in it, and we may pick one up once or twice today. You can also use it as a spindle gouge. A bowl gouge is a very good all-around tool. All right. Raise a little bit. You want it just about center where your tool contact would be. And the way you use a roughing gouge, hopefully you can see this, is or any tool with a bevel contact. When you make your bevel contact, it's not going to cut until you raise that up and it contact the bevel. And that's how you start your cut. You bring your tool, rub your bevel, bring your tool up until you just start to see a cut, and then you start cutting. And we will start off at probably about 500 RPM. You notice how I leaned over to the side and got out of the way? That's a lot of times that's when they fly off. And that's fast enough now for roughing. I'm going to show you what I mean about this. Can you hear it? I'm going to raise it up slowly until we start to see a cut. There it is. here, pick up the cut. You know what I did? I didn't put my face shield on. And y'all let me do that. Okay, I'm seated up. Always give her a test spin to make sure nothing's knocking or touching. Let me get a little more light on it, if I can get my light around here. And we're going to speed it up just a little bit. That's probably about 657 RPMs. I don't have a digital readout, but it's not pretty cool to know that. The faster the wood turns, the faster you can peel it off. And the faster, you know, that's that much faster, you'll get it trued up to where it's balancing good. I'm using my body. I've got this locked into me. I'm using my body to control the motion. This hand, all this hand is doing is holding it down. And this hand, I've got a little bit of control with it. And you can go both ways with this cut. I was just trying to get the camera good view. Close to having it round now. Pretty close, got just a little further to go. This is cherry, it's pretty hard wood. Actually, I may have told you wrong. I believe it's cherry. It might be pear. I got them mixed up over there. Those are bug trails. We don't like them. We don't like them. So we got them rounded down pretty well, and we can also use a spindle gouge. These work very well also. Never use it on the inside of a bowl. You can use it on end grain bowls or boxes. But that's a whole other subject. Same thing, you rub the bevel, bring it up and start making a cut, come across. Peels, ready to come off. It's a lot of fun. That wood's still a little bit green. Now we need to start thinking about the shape of our snowman and how we're going to make him. Obviously, this is going to be his hat. And, somewhere along here. Put in this little crow here. Okay, just about cut all the bugs out too. grab a pencil. It helps to mark off your project sometimes. It'll help to figure out where things are going to be. This is about where his hat brim will be. You can see that. Somewhere in there, and I want to make his hat frame about yay thick. That's the plan. This will be the outer circumference of his head, and then the next section of his body, and the other section of his body. Our snowman will have three balls. So let's dig away at the hat a little bit. Thinking about grab a parting tool, and we are going to define his brim. This is actually a 3/8 bowl gouge, but you can use it as a finger gouge also. It's smaller, so I can get into tighter spaces. Now, we'll define the bottom edge of his rim. there. And we'll continue with the spinning rods. Yes, I know I'm wearing a jacket. They tell you not to, but it was 33 degrees this morning. It is warming up fairly well, and I will be removing it here in just a bit. Actually, probably not too much longer. Smaller tools give you the ability to go into smaller places. Well, sometimes you need to touch it up with a parking tool. To find where his head connects to his hat. Now we're ready to start on his chin. And this is called a cone. You just skip, you're scooping it out like ice cream. That's the reason I drew that line. So I would go to the widest part of his head where it's going to be at. And then you just make both of these sides match up. I said these are great little practice projects. It's called a run back. Things happen. Another one. I've got to be honest. I haven't made one of these in a couple of years. So this is good practice for me too. His head has to be smaller than his body, right? And sometimes you have to switch and go off hand. Or left handed. If you're a righty. Which is awkward at first. It takes a little practice. It's looking fairly well. He's getting smaller, so that changed our tool angle. Getting better. I'm afraid that's probably not the best camera angle, is it? We'll have to come up with something. That's the unfortunate thing about working in a small space like this right on your porch. I don't have a lot of room for lights and cameras and stuff like that. So, maybe next time we'll move out in the yard. A little bit more shape than we do up here. I'm watching the profile at the top, kind of getting rounded off like a good snowman's supposed to do. Thank you. That's a little shear spring. You'll notice how things are just barely coming off. These little wispy, fine wispy hairs. They're barely taking them off. We're just smoothing them up a little bit, removing the tool marks. Bad. Now I'm grabbing a scraper just around this edge off. It's actually a negative rake scraper. Just around this edge off a little bit because it's so sharp. Over here. Anytime you got sharp edges like that and it's spinning, you don't want to get up against it. It'll cut you like a saw blade. It looks pretty good. You always take more off. You can't put it back on though. I'm not going to part him off just yet. He needs just a little bit of sand. Sandpaper, that is. We won't go overboard with it. Got a pretty good finish. I'd say about 100 or 120 would be a good place to start. Turn speed down. I know it's boring watching someone sand, but and it is one of the worst jobs about turning, or any woodworking actually. No one likes to sand it. And we're going to turn them the other way. I usually have a fan set up here. We'll get into that later on. Have it blowing over my shoulder and blow the dust away from me. I should have a respirator on. Don't do this at home. pretty good to me. We have to hand sand his head, the top of his hat. It won't take much. It's just a quick little project. And you've seen how long that's taken. Yeah, a little bit of decorating. He'll be a nice guy. We'll try to get that little nub on top of his hat down as small as we can. And we'll use a thin parting tool. Turn the lathe in the right direction. No woodturner's ever tried to turn or cut with a lathe going backwards. That'll come off easy. Now we just have to part him on the bottom. There you go. Nice little snowman. Thank you for watching. If you like it, subscribe, please.